Ni hao. This is probably the first phrase that a beginner picks up when learning Mandarin, and you would have learned that it is a greeting that means hello, whereby ni means you and hao, good, fine. Do you also know that the word hao expresses a lot more than just nice? In this lesson, we'll find out just how versatile this word is. First things first, are you aware that there are two ways to read this character? It can be read in the third tone, hao, and also in a fourth tone, hao. Good if you knew this, but if you didn't, well, now you do. Let's start from the third tone, hao. This is mostly an adjective, and the basic meaning is, as you know, good. It has several uses, and we'll be looking at five of the most common ones. So the fundamental meaning of hao is good, nice, fine. How do we use it then? Let's look at four structures. All-round hello. So I said that ni hao is literally you good. But specifically, what about you is good? Your situation, your condition, your state, your health. This would be clearer in its question form. Ni hao ma? How are you? Take away the question marker, ma, and you can look at the greeting ni hao as a shortened statement of I hope you're fine. What if you want to greet someone else? Simply change the subject, ni, to whoever it is.
大家好, 老师好, 同学们好, 叔叔好, 阿姨好.
We can also replace the person with a time word.
早上好, 下午好, 晚上好.
Let's have a look at other structures of this basic meaning, good. Predicate to describe the subject before it.
女儿这男朋友好，我喜欢。是吗？哪里好？人品好，头脑好，样貌好，样样好。今天天气真好。哪里好？热死了。Attribute
to modify the noun after it.
我有一个好消息和一个坏消息。 你要先听哪个? 好事不出门,坏事传千里。Expression
of agreement.
明天陪我一起去,好吗? 好啊。我们明天去吧。好。Let's
move on to the second meaning of 好. Easy. Placed in front of verbs, it indicates that something is easy to do. The opposite is 不好 or 难.
这支笔真好写。汉语难学吗? 不难学,很好学。这个句子不好懂,得改一改。And
now, the third meaning. Pleasant. Placed in front of some verbs, it indicates pleasantness on the senses. The opposite is 不好 or 难.
真好看的裙子,哪里买的? 这首歌一点都不好听,为什么这么流行? 这是我喝过最好喝的可可。我老婆以前做饭超好吃,不知道为什么现在做的不好吃了,越做越难吃。At
this point, you may be wondering if this third use of 好 could be easily confused with the second use. They both appear in front of verbs and even have the same opposite structure. If you think about it, they're both derivatives of the fundamental meaning of good. For example, 好写 is good to write, easy to write. And 好看 is good to look at, nice to see. While it may seem that this makes for ambiguous cases, it actually does not usually cause misunderstandings. Context makes it clear, and more importantly, combinations of pattern 3 are not that many. The following examples are more or less what you would encounter.
好看 好听 好吃 好喝 好闻 好玩 好受
As you can see, these are expressions that indicate feelings on the senses. Moreover, these combinations are already mostly seen as fixed compound words, so they hardly would make room for misunderstandings. Take a look at the following.
天哪 好看不好用的东西竟然这么好卖。这年头钱正好赚。
If there is possibility of being unclear, we could always use other ways of expression. Let's use
好看 and 好吃 as examples. 这本书很好看，我看了三遍了。字体放大就容易看了。这面不好吃，我吃不下。这面用勺子吃太辛苦了，用筷子吧。
And next, let's look at the fourth meaning. Complete. It is placed after verbs and acts as a result complement to indicate completion or satisfactory state of an action.
我吃好了，可以出发了。我没看好，能再示范一遍吗？好，我再示范一遍，你看好。汉语再难学，我也一定要把它学好。这封信真不好写，我写了半天也还没写好。
You might have noticed by now that word order in Mandarin is of utmost importance. The difference between pattern 4 and patterns 2 and 3 is simply a flip in the order, but the meaning is totally different.
好吃 is tasty, while 吃好 is to finish eating. 好看 is good looking, while 看好 is to look carefully. 好学is easy to learn, while 学好 is to learn well. 好写 is nice to write, while 写好 is to finish writing.
So, do be careful which word comes first. Finally, the last meaning of third tone 好 that we'll be looking at today. Very. This meaning of 好 is an adverb and comes before an adjective or a measure word to emphasize intensity. It is colloquial and emotive and often translated as very.So, quite, such, what?
好久不见。好可爱的小猫，真想带回家。这个人我见过好几次。你穿着衣服好好看呐。这个名字好难念呐。一点都不难念，我觉得好好念。
Moving on to the fourth tone, how? Fortunately,The fourth tone does not have as many uses as the third tone. Mostly, the problem would be in deciding whether it is the third tone or the fourth tone. In a fourth tone, it acts as a verb meaning to like. Let's have a look at some examples.
你有什么爱好？姐姐好动，妹妹好静。真是个好学的孩子。她从小就很好玩。他好面子，不会认错的。这个人好酒好财又好色，你千万不能跟他结婚呐。你这么好吃懒做，谁敢请你呢？你怎么这么好管闲事？
Sometimes you may be unsure if you're looking at the third tone or the fourth tone. In such cases, context is your only key.
这孩子太好玩了。我可以天天来跟他玩吗？这孩子太好玩了，真拿他没办法。真是好酒，自己一个人喝太可惜了。真是好酒，喝那么多伤身呐。
So, how was the lesson today? Was it
好学?
If you've enjoyed it, don't forget to like and subscribe. Till the next lesson,
再见。